Good morning，大家早。Last week we saw the 南派 and 塞派, and today we will see the Manipalab and pandas and the scikit-learn。好，那上个礼拜呢，我们稍微了解了一下南派跟塞派这两个套件。那这个礼拜我们将会来看 Manipal 跟 Pandas 这两个套件。And before the class, I need to announce that November 16 is our midterm project, and every group need to talk about your final project and how you want to prepare your final project and the process and the of the final project. And this is our meeting. And you will need to present the status, process and the material in November 16. Then that means this is 2 weeks later. And next week, night, we don't have class because the next week you need to prepare your midterm project. So we don't have class next week.
Pray.
那这个部分呢，就是在看今天的课程之前呢，就这样大家1月10号我们的期中考中开始，我们要报告我们的专题。那我们的期中专题呢，它跟期末专题它是息息相关的，也就是说，期中我们要报的是我们期末要做什么。那现在我已经做了哪些，也就是进度的部分，然后跟我们现在已经准备好的有哪些素材，然后要怎么样子来做成我们的期末专题。好，那也因为两个礼拜后就是我们的期中考周，所以按照我们的进度来说，就会是下个礼拜就会让大家来专心的准备我们的期中报告，所以下个礼拜我们就没有正式的课程在这里啊。换句话说，就是下个礼拜要上课。好 ，And here is the phone, and it need to write down your partner and like your department or your grade and your student ID and your name and your email. And this is your partner. And if you are in the sister school of university, then maybe you don't have need to write down this if you don't have any information about the department or grade or student ID. You just write down your name and your email. And then this column will need you to upload your code or your document and your material like in the GitHub or Google Drive and Dropbox. And here you just write down your share link like this this form. You can write down the share link like this one, and then to make me to access this cloud drive and see your materials. 好，那 好，那在我们的课程里面呢，等等我会公布我们要让大家写的一个表单。那这个表单就是我们组员跟就是组员的部分。那像是说我们是哪个系，然后或者是几年级，然后你的学号、姓名跟你的联络方式。那你的伙伴的部分也在这。那最后我们会有一个一栏是说，哎，我们之后我们的期中、期末的文件，或者是你所收集到的素材，或者是讲你有写程式码的话，都请放在你的云端空间，像是 GitHub、Google Drive 或 Dropbox，然后之后把那个分享的连结分享出来。那这样的话，就是我们就可以去看里面的内容，那到时候我们报告也是会用这样的一个方式，然后这样就不用插拔随身碟啊，或者是说要怎么样子交接，我们就会把你分享出来的连接放在这。OK，and this is the your group ID and you can choose one you like and then November 16, we will use the random selection function to say our presentation order. And this is will be the randomly to choose. 好，那前面的 group ID 呢，就是你可以选你自己喜欢的一个号码来作为你的组员的号码。那我们的报告顺序呢，会是在11月16号那一天，然后用随机程式，然后帮大家抽出大家的顺序，然后就按照那个顺序来报告。And here we do a example like this one。好，那我们现在先来做一个范例，来让大家知道这要怎么来做填写。Okay, and this is the example. Like you choose your group ID and then fill out your department grade and student ID and your name and your email and also to your member. And then put your share link here. And this link will can access your material, your project and your final project. And right now this link is our this form. And later I will put this one in the Teams and the Moodles. 好，那这边就是我们一个例子，就是说你在前面先选择你想要的组员编号，然后再接下来就依序填上你的系籍、学号，然后姓名跟 email。那同样，你的伙伴也是一样。 然后最后呢，就是再放上你这边刚刚所分享出来的那个云端分享的连结，然后他可以去看到你的期中、期末跟你所准备的一些素材的部分。那目前这个连结就是我们这一张表，所以你点进去会看到就是这一张表。那晚一点我会把这个连结把它放在 Teams 跟 Moodle 上，那这样可以让大家来填写这个内容。And then we see the Manipulalab. And Manipulalab, this is a package for drawing, especially for present your data. And then you can use the feature or the picture to show your result. And Manipulalab, this is the three-word combination.Like the Manipulalab, plus plot, and the plus library. So the picture drawn by Manipulalab, it seems like the Manlab. 好，那 Manipulalab 呢？它就是一个专门可以拿来做绘图用的套件。那这个最主要就是要希望你，所以你的资料在呈现的时候，只要能用图示的方式，或者是图表的方式来呈现的话，它会比较容易让人了解，所以它就是专门用来画图的。那再来的话，就是 Manipulalab， 它知道它是从 Manlab， 然后 plot 跟 library 这三个字所组合出来。那它画图的时候，它是参考Manlab 最后呈现的样子，所以你会发现用 Manipulalab 画出来的图，它跟 Manlab 有点像。Okay. And then we see the Manipulalab. Usually we use the Manipulalab. We use this function, or you can see use this model, and we need to import and the Manipulalab dot pyplot, and because the name of this manipulalab.pyplot is too long, so we usually use the short name like us plt. Okay. And in this module, we can draw this kind of picture like the line chart and the histogram or.Name. This is the bar chart and the histogram and the scatter chart and the pie chart and the subplot. And the function for the line chart, the easy way is use the plt and the x and y. And x means the x point in your place and in your drawing, and Y is the Y point in your place. And the bar chart is use the plt.bar, and you can input X and Y. And histogram is like the plt.hist, and the scatter is plt.scatter, and this is for X and Y. And pie chart you need to draw the percentage, so you put the percentage for your parameter, like plt.pi. And subplot, you can use the plt.subplot syz to draw the subplot. Okay. And in the Jupyter notebook, you need to use this to show the figure on screen. Or if you don't type this,command, you will not see the picture. Later, we will do the example for this one. 好，那在 FarLab 里面呢，我们比较常用的模组是下面这个，就是我们常用的模组拿来画图的有这个，是MemFarLab 点 pyplot， 是我们常用的一个模组。但是因为这个名字太长，那我们只要每次使用的时候都要打这么长的字的话，会觉得很耗时间，所以我们就会用缩写。那缩写的部分，目前就是大家习以为常，就是 PLT 这三个英文字，所以就是会写 import memplotlib 点 py， PLT plot 二十PLT 这一块。那在这个模组里面呢，常用的又有六个图，那分别就是，这叫折线图，然后跟条状的直方图或者是横方图，那这个我这边我打错，应该是 bar chart， 不是 histogram， 然后或者是这种，历史的或者是折线，这叫散布图，然后或者是圆饼图，或者是，subplot， 这团不知道怎么翻译啊。那在使用的部分呢，就是画折线图的线图的部分，它最简单就是用 PLT， 然后你给它 SY， 那 SY 就是分别表示你的点在你的坐标图上的 S 跟 Y 它的大小的值给它。那做长方图或者是直方或者是横方图的这种，你也是给它的坐标，它这样就可以画成它一块一块的区块。然后 history 也是一样 ，sy。然后散布图的话，你用 scatter sy 给它，就用打点的方式来呈现。那圆饼图呢，它最主要就是画你的百分比，所以就是给一个参数就好。那或者说你可以给它数值，然后它会自己去算它占的其他所有数值的百分之几。然后或者是跟 subplot， 那 subplot 就是 syz 会需要给它。好，那在用 memplotlib 的时候呢，在我们使用 Jupyter Notebook 的时候，我们必须要使用这个指令，就是 inline 的指令，然后这样才能把你的图秀在你的萤幕上。没写的话，它就不会秀图出来。那我们等等可以用一个例子，来为大家来展示一下，有加这个跟没加这个它的结果。Okay. And this one is the example. And this example we want to draw the sine function. And sine need to use in the NumPy because this is well easy to them.Us to draw the sine function in our memplotlib. And first one, we need to import numpy as np. And this is so in last week. And then use the memplotlib.pyplot, our drawing module, and as a plt. And then we want to show the figures on our screen. So we use this command, memplotlib inline. Okay. And then we want to draw set up the X point. So we use the linspace to automatically generate our S point, like the range is minus 10 to 10.And minus 10 to 10, there are 100 points here. And then we want to draw our feature in our screen. And this is our first feature. When you say this, when you use this command plt.figure, and the memplotlib will.Automatically generate a feature for you to draw. And that means if you write this command after this drawing, and it will automatically generate the second picture, and later we will see the example. And then we want to draw our line chart, so we use plot dot plot and set our x and our x is this one, and then we say his y, and y is equal to np dot sin and your x. And the final one, that means we want to let our point like a point, so we use this one. Okay, and this will join like this one. Let me see our Jupyter notebook. Put on the desktop and generate a new file. And then we copy the source code to our它可以用那个也可以，那个也可以。And you can use Jupyter Notebook or you can use Colab, and it's okay.The first one, we don't need this one. We will see if we don't have this command, the picture will not show in our screen. Wait a minute.Okay. Okay. Well, in Jupyter Notebook, it since it default say the this command in our code.好，那我们再回来看一下，就是这边的范例是指说，我们想要在我们的图形上画一个 sin 的图形，那我们要怎么去来做它？所以它这边就是用一个自动画点的方式，自动生成点的方式来跟大家说。那第一个是它想要自动产生 sin 的图形，然后它就是用 np 点 sin， 因为 np 里面它有一个 sin 的 function 可以拿来做，你给它一个值，它可以给你 sin 的对应值，那这样就可以拿来做 x 跟 y 的坐标。所以因为它有用到 np 点 sin 的这个 function， 所以在一开始我们会需要用到NumPy 这个套件，所以在前面。就会加 import numpy as np， 因为我们会来用到。那再来就是我们要把今天所要用的 memplyb 放进来，所以就把这一行 import memplyb 点 py plot as plot 放进来。那再来，正常来讲，应该这个没写的话，它应该不会产生图，但是刚刚实验里面它却看到图，所以有可能。Python 他自己认为想说你看到他画图他会觉得是要你会秀到你的荧幕上，所以他把这可能已经把它放在里面，不过为了保险起见我们还是需要加这个指令进来。好，那再来的是我们要生成我们的 X 轴的坐标，那我们这边就是用上一个礼拜所看到的，它会自动在你所给定的起始点跟终止点这两个点之间，然后生成它的间距，就是相同间距下的点，好，所以我们就用 namespace 这个 function， 所以就可以从指定说它会从负十到十，然后它中间是100个点，那就可以自动生成等距离的点出来。好，那这个是 S 的部分。那接下来呢，就是这个指令，它指的是说，当我们要画一张图的时候，就给它这个指令，就是 plt.figure。好，那换句话说，假如我们要画第二张图，就会再写另外一个 plt.figure， 它这样就会生成第二张图。假如没有写到这个函数的时候呢，我们在后面再画图，它就会把这些的东西，它都把它放在同一张图里面。好，那最后我们要画 side 的图，所以就是 s 轴跟 y 轴放进来。那最后这个部分是说打点是要用这个点的部分来呈现。好，那所以刚刚我们就是在我们的 Jupyter Notebook 这边来做一个练习。好，那所以我们就画一个跟范例一样的图。 And this is the code copied from our example. And then we can see this will draw the figure like this one. And you can see because we set S equal to minus 10 to 10, and there are 100 points here. So you can see this. The smallest value is minus 10, and the maximum value is 10, so here. And then this, there are 100 points here. And the y is the sine of x, so minus 10, sine of minus 10 is equal to 0.5 here, and the 10 is here. So you can draw the sine function here. And then if we want to draw the cosine function, and then you can use this one. And you can use cosine. And we want to use another simple to draw the point. So we can use like this one. And we draw this again. And you can see this is the cosine line, and the MATLAB will automatically use another color for your second line. And you can see that if we don't use the figure here, and the MATLAB will seem you want to draw these two lines together in the one figure.You will see the two lines are in our figure. And if you the PLT plot here and draw your cosine. And then you will see the MATLAB will generate two figure, and one is for sine and another is for cosine. So this is to make MATLAB to create another figure here. So you can see that these two, the difference is here. If we want to use this command to generate the second or thirdfigure. 好，那刚刚我们在这个范例里面就是看到 第一个是用 sin 画出来的图形，那因为它的 S 轴就是负十跟十之间，所以我们可以看到它的 S 轴在负十跟十之间，然后对应的蓝色的点，它就会画出这个 sin 的值出来。那接下来我们只要画 cos 的话，那我们就可以在后面一行再接一个plt.plot， 然后接上你的指令。那后面我们为了要让它有区别，所以我们就把它星星改成这个星星，那就可以看出来它的图就跟前面的图就会不一样。后面的图有这个星星的部分，那同时因为是第二条线，所以 MemphaLab 它会自动帮我们的第二条线换成不同颜色以示区别。好，那这个是我们就用这个plt.figure 来做一张图，所以你后面所有画图的指令 ，MemphaLab 它就会认为说你是要把所有的画图的程式都把它画在一起，所以你就看到全部都会长在一张图里面。那假如之后你想要用第二张图来表示或第三张图来表示的话，你就会在就会需要在中间再加另外一个 plt.figure。那像这两个程式的差别就是差在我 sin 跟 cos 之间有再放一个这个 plt.figure 出来，那你就可以看到画出来的结果，它就是 sin 是一张图，然后 cos 是另外一张图。那这是他们两个之间 的差别。And of course, if you want to use two lines, you can, like this one, you use two commands to draw, to draw the curve. And you can use this one to combine together. For this one, this is the first line. And then you use the comma and to write your second line's function here. Here. Okay. And this will be the second line, and use this one for our example, and then we take break. Okay, and you can use this one. You can combine these two code like this one, and you can draw the picture, and you will get the same picture here. 好，那刚刚是说我们画线的时候画任何的图，你都可以自己一条一条的下指令。那这时候有时候可能会觉得说，同样的东西为什么要一直重复下？这个是对于第一次接触的人来说，他这样会比较清楚他现在画到哪一条线，或者是他画到哪一个图表。好，那习惯了之后呢，也可以把它变成是两条线的，把它合在一起。那它合并的方式呢，很简单，就是你加个逗点，然后再把你第二条线、第三条线的 SY 跟你想要画的样貌，把它给写在后面。那这样的话就可以把第二条线画在一起，我们刚就可以把它画在一起，那就会像是这个样子，你就可以用这样子合并起来之后，它就会画在一起。那你可以看到这两张图它是长得一模一样的。 OK, and we take 10 minutes break and then we come back to our course. 好，那我们现在这边先休息十分钟，那我们等会再回来看后续的部分。